Joining us now is Shan Wu. He's a CNN legal analyst. So first, Shan, on the law, just so folks understand, myself as a layman, do public comments by an official pre-appointment like this, do they create a legal justification for recusal? I mean, he wrote on CNN, he made other public comments criticizing the Mueller investigation. Is that legally relevant?
Yeah, great question. I think that's a little bit of a gray area. This is very different than the reason that Sessions had to recuse himself. Mm-hmm. His comments here certainly make him look biased, but the particular regulation, the CFR regulation that governs the recusal that Sessions invoked, goes to whether a Justice Department employee has a personal or political relationship with an entity or person under investigation. And that's arguably implicated here. And normally he would recuse. I mean, these sorts of recusals are usually done very quietly outside of the spotlight, mm-hmm. mostly because the department and the higher-ups want to preserve the integrity and the public appearance of the department. They don't want to have a lot of attention called to what conflict there might be, so it's usually done very quietly. People err on the side of recusal. Sessions was in a very different position. I mean, two things. One, he was a surrogate for the campaign. The campaign was being investigated. And two, really, he arguably made a false statement during his confirmation hearings. I mean, he denied having any meetings with the Russians. So that's very, very different. But no question that he looks very biased here. And no question that if I were advising him, you know, if I was counsel to this AG, I would tell him it would be a good idea to recuse.
Yeah, I would not hold your breath on that one. Senator Chuck Schumer said to Jake Tapper yesterday, look, it's a constitutional crisis, his words, if Whitaker doesn't recuse himself. But if you look back a long time ago, 1989, the Supreme Court ruled in U.S. v. Eaton that indeed a temporary appointment to a primary position, a principal office like this, is constitutional if the person has served in that office for 90 days, which Whitaker has. So is it a constitutional crisis?
I don't think so. There's some very well-respected legal experts who have weighed in saying that they think this is an unconstitutional appointment. I don't agree. I mean, when I was in the department, there were numerous instances where we had temporary acting people, sometimes staff people, if the attorney general was traveling or the deputy was unavailable. I think so long as the duration is properly limited, that should be okay. I mean, I think it raises some interesting questions, but I don't think that it's an unconstitutional appointment. But if it became an attempt to declare, let's say, by presidential proclamation that he is the AG, I think that would definitely be problematic.
Final question before I let you go. How long can he serve Whitaker before he would require Senate approval?
I believe that the time is around 200 days. I'm not 100% clear on the exact amount of time, but the duration needs to be limited. And I think one problem is that they have not been talking about it being a limited duration, and they need to quickly say this is an acting situation and we're going to get a nominee in place.
Because I should note that a lot could happen in the Mueller investigation during those
days. 200, yeah,
period of time
days.
In which Whitaker is overseeing and has a lot of power to limit what Mueller could do.
Absolutely.
Shan Wu, thanks very much as always.
Good to see you. All right.